The state of emergency, it coming on the heels of 11 murders in 4 days, and given the fact that we've had 22 persons arrested, suspected of being involved in gang warfare, is a huge success within 48 hours. 4 persons were arrested, 2 bandits were killed yesterday morning. We have had no murders in the space of 48 hours, coming on the heels of 11 murders in the space of 4 days. If you don't consider that to be an outstanding success, I think that something is wrong with the maths. But certainly, the large majority of citizens in this country consider the seizure of the arms and ammunition, the death of 2 bandits at the hands of the police, and the rounding up of 22 persons, in addition to a gun found in the Gumatin yesterday that led to the arrest of 4 persons and 2 suspected of murder, to be outstanding success compared to what we have been accustomed to in this country.
But if you're going to implement a state of emergency, you must have objectives that rise above the normal objectives, so that finding 6 guns doesn't justify a state of emergency. Arresting 30 people somewhere in East Port of Spain on a raid doesn't justify a state of emergency.
I asked the Attorney General a short while ago about that very thing, and he described it as a resounding success. I thought he would have said, well, by tomorrow we'll have the big guns.
Well, I would prefer to put it a different way. Here's my complaint. I would have thought that by the time you decide to declare a state of emergency, you have a good idea where the stashes of guns are, and as soon as you declare the state of emergency, your teams move in, and in my graphic imagination, you find stashes of guns and you fill up big boxes with them, seal them, and drop them in the Gulf of Paria. And the other objective must be that the emergency regulations provide for detention orders. So I expected that I would have woken up the morning after the state of emergency declared to find that Nelson Island was full and there was a waiting list of people to get in, because I would have expected Mr. Big, or all of the Mr. Bigs, to be on the list. And the reason we would use a state of emergency for that is that due process has been stymied for over five to 10 years. Due process has been stymied. And while I am very much in favor of due process normally, we have got to a stage where the country cannot take it anymore. And I think everybody is in favor of a state of emergency. In principle, they are concerned about how it will work and how it will affect them. So I believe that the opening gambits of this state of emergency have not met my expectations. I think the country is heading for a big disappointment, because I have not seen any of these big objectives being accomplished. And I want to emphasize, you know, that a state of emergency is not for holding 30 people in Nelson Street. It's for holding the people who are bringing in the stuff that they're dealing with in Nelson Street and who are financing the stuff. So I would expect when the boat is heading down to Nelson Island, you'd have a few jacket and tie fellas in there too. The government's communications have been awful. And to be driven now to saying that 6 arrests and or 6 guns and 30 arrests is a success of the state of emergency. But that's normal police work. A state of emergency is an extreme measure designed to get at much bigger fish and much bigger objectives. So I am very disappointed. And the reason why I'm, you know, making such a fuss about this is the country wants this. The country cannot take another disappointment. And as I've been saying all day, if you play this ace and you don't hang jack, it's going to be impossible to play it again. And if we devalue the threat of a state of emergency, we devalue what a state of emergency is designed to accomplish, then we have taken a step backwards, not a step forward. Hence my disappointment.